In this video, I'm going to show you how to use the text tools in Affinity Publisher. So we're going to change fonts, font styles, font sizes, colors, like a fill color, a border color, resizing, spacing, line spacing, all that stuff. So I'm just going to create a new document. Doesn't matter what size. This is just to show you guys how to use the text tool. Okay, so in Affinity Publisher, there are two main text tools, the Artistic Text Tool and the Frame Text Tool. To be honest, they kind of do the same thing. So I prefer to use the Artistic Text Tool because when I left-click and type something, I'll just put today, so Tuesday, this box will automatically appear around the text and it is very compact. It's very close to the letters. There's no extra space. And if you have multiple things on your page, it just becomes a lot less cluttered when the box is more compact. And by comparison, if we use the Frame Text Tool, we're going to left click and drag to create similar like a text box in Microsoft Word, if you've ever used that. And it's very bunched up to the top of the box, if I make it bigger. And there's just lots of wide line spacing, like it's such wide that it's now hidden. This red mark here means I need to expand my box out. And it's just, I find it's a bit more clunky to use. So you can use it if you want to, but I'm just going to stick to the Artistic Text Tool for me. You can change the font style, colors, and everything the same way. Doesn't matter which one that you use. So at the moment, it's on Arial. If you have downloaded fonts from the internet, they will automatically load into Affinity Publisher. You don't have to do like an extra step. Your computer will register that that font is now available for you to use after you've installed it. If you have installed it and you still don't see it in Affinity Publisher, just close it down and then reopen it and it should appear in this menu here. So one of the ones that I've downloaded and like to use is called Anton. I think it's a really good block font, simple and it's clear to read. So if we just click on it, we can then change the font to that. And you can change multiple fonts at the same time. If I just copy and paste, and I'll make this one say Monday. If we click on the little cursor up here, the move tool, left click and drag, make sure that you have your light blue completely over the boxes and you'll see that border appear. If you don't, you go like this. See how it's not selecting everything? It's not selected anything, actually. You need to completely cover it to select things if you want to change them all at once. So if I want to change this to agency font, for example. So there's plenty of fonts that you can download off the internet. Some of my favorite resources are DaFont, FontZone, FontSquirrel. And if there's a font that you know that you like that you want to download, just type like Anton free font download, for example. If you're going to be making printables to sell, make sure that you check that commercial use is allowed. And in particular, you want a commercial use, no credit required, which might require you to pay a little bit more for those rights for the license. Up to you if you want to use free fonts or paid fonts, very much personal preference. And you can see that there's plenty in here to choose from anyway. This is just the A's and you can see how long this thing's going to go. So there's plenty of pre-install, this one's a good one, to use. And once you find a font that you like, you can click this little heart here in favorites. And if we go to favorites, it's right there for quick reference. So you don't have to keep scrolling or manually typing it in. So I have to keep typing in Anton. Oh, it's already on Anton. Let's say I had this font here and I wanted to change it to Anton. And then you type. So it's just quicker if you put it in your favorites. You can also see in your recent and your used. So if you have multiple fonts in your document and you can't remember which font you used where, you can just go to use and it'll give you a preview of what it looks like. So that's another handy tool as well. So I've got it on regular at the moment because that's the only option that comes with this font. If I go back to Arial, if it will let me, oops, because I hadn't selected it. Sorry, let's get off of used and go to all. And let's go to, it was Arial. And for this font, there are multiple styles that we can choose from. If you have downloaded a custom font, all of this probably won't be available. Maybe sometimes you'll get like a regular, a bold or italic. It's not really a big deal because you can still edit the font or customize it this way. So you can still go bold, click on our text and go bold, italics, underline. I usually will only do things in bold, like for headings for a printable. So if the title is to-do list, I'll probably put that in bold just so it's easier to see, especially for a title. I want it to stand out a bit more than the rest of the text on my printable. For a font like this one, which is already quite bold, it doesn't even have an option for bold and I wouldn't use it anyway. I think that's good enough as it is. You can increase the font size by either clicking in this box and just typing in what you want, or you can click the drop down and then it'll show you a preview of how big it's going to be. So that's handy as well. Now it jumps from things like 20 to 24 and 24 to 30. That's okay. You can just type in like 28 and it will resize to that, even though it's not like a pre-filled size in here. There's all these other options up here, which I don't use them, to be honest. I feel like that's more if you're doing like writing a book or a magazine or something, and there's all like indenting and paragraph styles and all that stuff. I don't bother with that. I don't need it for making printables. The other thing you can do is align your text. So it doesn't matter if you've used the artistic text tool, but if you've got the frame text tool, for example, let's go Friday. If you press Control A, it'll highlight all of the text in that box that we've created, and we can align it either left, middle, or to the right. And you can use all of these as well, like justify your text. So if I go Saturday, for example, and I just need to expand that out, just get it out of the way. Okay, so here, if I only wanted to select one of the words, so Control A is all. If you only want one, just left click and drag to select that, and then you can edit just that one. Oops, let's go just 10. And you can see that it's shrunk smaller. And if you want to do all, just remember Control A. You can also change your font color this way. So it's on black at the moment, but there's really good color tools in Affinity Publisher. So I like to use the RGB hex sliders, and that will give me the option to either enter an RGB code or use a 6-digit hex code. If you want white text, if you've got, say, a colored background on like a heading or like a table or something, I like to have colored background with white text. The color code for white is 6Fs. I literally just press and hold F a bunch of times and then press enter, and it'll automatically enter in 6 for me. If you want black, it's 6 zeros. Sorry, zeros, not O's. And that will make it black. And the reason I do that is just it's a lot quicker than going 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6. Just press and hold and you get the color that way. You can click around in the color picker here and choose whatever you want. You can change the opacity, so that'll make it a bit more see-through. It's pulling the white that's behind it. I don't really use opacity for text. I mainly use that for shape fill. So if you haven't already, I do have another video on how to use the color tools in more detail if you want to see, but you can see a recent here. There's plenty of colors to choose from in these pop-up menus. You can do gradient on a text as well. And if you want to color match something, if you click this tool here and hover over it, we can now make it black, and it will show, should show in the color menu over here. Doesn't want to do it. But anyway, you can color match and it'll show up over here, and you can get the color that way, the color swatch, if you want to match things. I have a proper tutorial on how to use the color tools, so maybe watch that one if you want more details. So over here in the right menu, you might see layers at the moment. If we go to character, it'll bring up these same functions that we see up the top here, except for some reason they don't show the background color or a stroke or an outline color up the top here. If you want to access those features, you have to use this menu here on the right. So at the moment, I have no outline on my text. So whenever you see this like line through, it means there's nothing. And that's the same for colors, for anything, for shapes or text, this means no outline. So if I zoom in, we can add one. If you click in here, and I'll just go back to colors. And let's go pink, for example, it's on 0.2. If we click the number, we can increase it to say 0.5 is probably still too much because my font's so small. Let's increase it actually. Let's go like size 30. Now it'll be a bit more obvious. Can drag it up as well if you want to see. So this is really good if you want to do two color tone text. So I've got this hot pink. If I change the fill color to a lighter pink, then it starts to coordinate and looks good. And you can also do strike through. Not sure why you would need that, but it's there if you want it, and you just click on it to take it off. Sorry, click on the none. Should take it off. For some reason it's not removing it. Let's just go to the N1. Okay, so now that we've removed that, we can use this tool here to put text on an angle. I don't think you really need that for making printables. It's there if you want it. If you want more of a space between your letters, if we go, say, 200, it's stretched it out a lot, so much so that I need to expand this box out, and it looks terrible. So let's not use that tool. It looks terrible when it's squished as well. I'm just going to go with 100 back to what it was to begin with. If you have multiple lines of text, you can already see that it won't fit the box because of this red thing that appears. So if we drag that down and out this way, we can change the distance between our lines. So 31 is quite a lot. Even though our font is big, we can pull that back a bit. So you can press the arrow keys to increase or decrease, or you can just type in the distance that you want, such as line spacing. They say leading override, but I always think of it as line spacing. You can change these as well. To be honest, don't touch them. I don't feel the need to, but they're there if you want to space things out a bit more. If you want to resize your text, you can either just change the font size up here, or if you have one of the corners, if you choose one of the corners, you can left click and drag it out. I'm holding the shift key to maintain the proportions, but even that is starting to look a little like stretched to me. I'd rather just change it by typing in the number, and I think that doesn't look quite so squished. This looks a bit stretched to me. I think it looks much better if you just type in the number and change your text size that way. There are some other functions down here. I don't really use them. I don't really feel the need. If you are maybe doing a recipe book, you might want to use fractions for like half cup, for example. So that's there if you want it as well. I can only speak English, but there are some language tools there if you need them. It's pretty much it. Paragraph is basically the same as your characters menu. This one here, this leading override, this here will basically do the same thing. See how it's changing the line spacing? So we've got that there, space after paragraph. And you can indent things. So if you had a like a monthly calendar and you didn't want your numbers to be quite so close to the borders of each box, you can enter it in here and it'll indent. See how it's not touching right on the edge. So if this was a box, you have a bit of space now. So that's really useful for that as well. And that's pretty much all the tools that I use for text. We have text styles, but again, that to me is if you're writing a lot of text, not just for a couple of words like we would need for a printable. So I hope you found this video helpful. Don't forget to have a look at the tutorial I did on how to use the color tool, including how to color match things. That's all in that video, which will be linked down below. Don't forget to subscribe. I do have a few more Affinity Publisher tutorials coming soon, and I also have an e-course where I teach how to make printables using this software, and I'll have that link down below as well.